In a sense, also becomes symbolic of the perpetual blessing of the saint, which is captured in that physical space. So that people and devotees and worshippers come back from time to time, take water from that spring, drink that water from that spring, and in a sense interiorize that perpetuity or become a part of that perpetuity.
So also look at the similarity. Amrita Bari of the Hindus, they are being replaced by Ave Hayat. Hayat means Zindagi, Ave means water. Ave Hayat or Ave Zindagi. This is the Ave Hayat or Amrita Bari, the Muslim version. Because Ave is water is related to life, Zindagi. So Ave Zamzam is recreated in a distant geographical position.
So it's many things combined at one. It's the spiritual blessings of the saint, it's a charisma, it's a sense of perpetuity, it's a sense of that spiritual power which is being continued across temporality. So temporality cannot bound the charisma and the spiritual power of the saint. It is being carried over through a very medium which is produced by nature itself, which is not manufactured artificially. So the spirit and the charisma of the saint is being perpetuated through a natural medium. As he returns to nature after his physical demise, his blessings and charisma is also perpetuated through that same medium of nature.
Some people will associate this with the popular culture, but others will say that he has to be maintaining proximity with the Islamic high tradition, because water is also necessary for ablution, spiritual cleansing. Before offering the prayer, you have to clean yourself sufficiently. So from that perspective also this use of water can be interpreted, defined. So both sides can legitimize themselves by offering their own version of water and their ability.